wonderful Sagittarians. I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. Those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love life or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Sagittarians, it's a big month. We have a solar eclipse and we have Mercury retrograde that started on the 20th of May. And it carries on being so till about 23rd of June. Now, during a Mercury retrograde, it's never a great time to be buying new things. It's not a great time to be specially investing in heavy ticket items. It's not a great time to be traveling. It's not a great time to be starting a new job. It's not a great time to be starting a new relationship. It's a great time to revise, research, and revisit things that could be lying pending for you. It's a wonderful time to be backing up your data. It's also a good time, especially for those of you who are looking at traveling, to ensure that all your travel plans are in place. I would suggest check not just twice, but thrice, and then again some more to ensure that everything is in place. We have a solar eclipse on the 10th of this month. Eclipses are sometimes disruptive. They shake up and lead us to major life events or more subtle life changes. Eclipses also carry the signature of change. They shake us up, turn us around, and ask us to adapt to changing conditions. The house an eclipse falls in shows us the area of life we will be asked to grow beyond what we've previously known. You're already ready to experience a rapid infusion of new awareness in this specific house. What is really interesting to note is that eclipses run through the zodiac every 19 years. So when the eclipse occurs, try and think what happened to you 19 years ago at this. Is that a core theme that is being played out again? Is something that you need to be looking at. An eclipse in astrology, whether it is a lunar eclipse or it is a solar eclipse, it brings about unexpected events or life-changing moments. Fortunately, solar eclipse tends to bring about new beginnings and new opportunities. On the 3rd of June, we have Venus that is joining Mars and it moves into your house of joint finances, resources. It is the house of sexuality and it is also the house of transformation and power struggles. Now, this is a wonderful combination. Mars and Venus is going to be encouraging you to collaborate effectively. It's asking you to keep your ego in check, Sagittarians. Especially where maybe you're trying to get some work out, or it could be in certain cases where you are the employee and you know there's somebody who's there in authority where you do not really see eye to eye. But the best way to go about it would be to come halfway. So try and maintain a balance wherein that you can not just get your work done or deliver your work, yet maintain peace and keep away light and easy energy. On the 10th, we have a solar eclipse that is there in your house of relationships. This is a very interesting eclipse because eclipses normally, they fall in pairs. So if there is an eclipse in first house, it's also going to be lighting up your relationship house over here. So there could be some change as far as your partnership, your whether it is your business or your personal partnership, that could change. There could be either some shakeup that could happen to your intimacy. Maybe you could just feel slightly taken aback by what gets revealed to you during this time. It can also be that something comes to light, something that you have sort of suspected but you have not known, but that sort of comes up more clearly. It's something that you can't avoid anymore. Also, these are the questions you will be asking yourself, that who am I in this relationship? Who will I become if the relationship carries on? And for some of you, it can be that the relationship is wholly absorbing. It's just following you to a place or to a point wherein that you're losing your own sense of self. So you will be wanting to hold on to your individuality in this relationship or in this partnership. Like I said, it speaks for both. It could be a work relationship as well, wherein that you are... you could have this sense of losing your identity, or you need to be making or specifying or defining your own space and saying, you know, this is what I bring to the table, or this is what I am good at. Also, for some of you, this solar eclipse is asking you to define your USP. Maybe that is something what you had all along till now has become stale news. Maybe you need to be sharpening your skills. Maybe you need to be coming up with something more. You need to be identifying within yourself that what is it? What value do you bring on the table? On the 12th, we have Mars that moves into your house of expansion of the mind. It is also the house of long distance travel, dealing with foreign clients, or even people from different cultures and at different ethnicities. And this is also about deepening your spirituality. So a lot of you could be dealing with maybe your business partners who are in different countries. You could be negotiating. You could be maybe sending your work across. Maybe some of you will be making that long distance travel. Maybe you could be traveling overseas somewhere. On the 21st, we have Sun and Venus also that come and join in this house of long distance travel. And it's encouraging you to learn more about your business. It's asking you to expand your mind. It's asking you to open up your mind. On the 23rd, we have Mercury, which goes direct, and a great time if you have been looking at getting married or starting a new relationship or a job or a project. Now is the time that you can move ahead over here. We're closing the month on the 24th. We have a full moon that is set in your house of money, and it is resonating with Pluto. So something is come to, either it's come to an end or it has come to. It is reaching that point of ending, and the good news is that something new may have started for you. So it could be that you have put a business venture on the back burner and now you're starting something new. Maybe you've started a new business or you've been thinking about it, and there is much more clarity about how it is that you want to generate more money. For some of you, you could have started another revenue stream for yourself. You could be earning more through another. Maybe you have supplemented your income by a second job or a second business opportunity. And this is something which is not new, Sagittarians. You may have had this in your plan for the longest of time, but this is the time where it will start sort of fructifying. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Sagittarians. I'll see you again soon. And thank you so much for watching.